Our windows are falling out.
Yep, they are. Well, we woke up this morning to, we're leaving Huntington Bay, somewhere on Long Island, and we're going to head towards the northeast side of Long Island this morning, but we got like 55 miles to go, so we wanted to leave a little bit early. So it's daytime, but I don't think we're leaving just yet because it looks like this out there. And maybe the camera's not capturing it, but you can't see more than like 20 feet in front of the boat. It's just like a complete whiteout. Lots of fog. I guess Long Island's very foggy. So we're going to wait a little while, and hopefully the fog burns off a little bit. There's going to be no real sailing today. There's like 4 knots of wind. So we're just going to motor along the whole north side of Long Island and get to either they got some weird Indian names here. Montauk? Something like that. Or some beach that's kind of on the north end. The northeast end of Long Island. So that's where we're heading to today. Young hearts there all alive, filled with questions and hope, sleepless nights. It made no difference, it didn't change. We gave our bell away, our ship's bell away, not realizing we needed it. So we need to get a new ship's bell for reasons like this.
Sun is finally starting to burn off the fog, but you can see there is no wind anywhere. A little bit way out there, but flat water today. We're almost to the North Fork, and you know, we're so used to beaches in the Bahamas being beautiful white sand. Well, this is a little bit different. This is a New York State beach. Not quite as easy on the feet.
Here, I'm fully protected. Here, I've got no protection whatsoever. I have no protection.
What kind of protection?
Here. Here. There's like sea glass here. I think they're just finding old Coors Light bottles. So we are in Long Island, somewhere in the north side, close to North Fork, over on the Long Island Sound. There's some therapy, and there's Farley, and there is. I think it's Connecticut, maybe Rhode Island, but yeah, beautiful place. Now we're going to visit our friends Howard and Amy. They live right up the road, actually. They just live like a mile up that way, so they're going to come down to the beach, and we're going to have some beach wine and cheese on the beach. I should have brought a hat.
A beautiful day, there's no wind, so we're motoring. Never make it on my own. Now we've got Captain Jeff and First Mate Howard over there.
Teaching Jeff how to sail.
Howard lives here. That's what he.
Hi!
We're coming into the North Fork of Long Island. Long Island.
Long Island.
Long Island, say it right.
Our windows are falling out.
Yeah, they are.
We were in Fort Lauderdale a month ago, and we know this is kind of a problem. It's a sealant problem that these windows have. And we were talking to some friends who were having their windows rebedded, and asked them, "Well, how did you know that it was time? Because if you pushed on it, nothing happened." And they said, "If you look at it from the outside, It looks very, very dark black all around where the seal is. And when that starts to change to light gray, it means it's separated. And we looked and we pushed on the windows in Fort Lauderdale last month and everything seemed to be fine. Well, it isn't now. We were washing the windows here in North Fork of Long Island the other day. And we noticed, oh, we've got a lot of this light gray all the way around. And we pushed on the windows and sure enough, they have separated from the boat. Can you see that?
Yeah, it's hard to see, but it's
totally separated.
They're separated. And
so we tried to pull, I don't know, I'm not sure what this is. Apparently this is part of the seal and this is flaking off. So the seal on the window side is not sticking anymore. It seems to be coming off all over. I pulled this out with tweezers and this window is off from about here all the way down. Now it seems to be holding up here, so.
So what are we gonna do?
Well, we're gonna do two things. The first thing we're gonna do.
And this is just temporary though.
Right, this is temporary because we have an appointment in, where is it, Bell? I don't know, somewhere in Rhode Island. We have an appointment to go in and have these fixed properly, but they need 10 days. And we bought some sealant, I forgot what it is.
Sikaflex sealant of some sort.
Is that what we bought? Some sort of Sikaflex, I forgot. And we're gonna pump it down in here to hold it on. And then we got this idea from our friend Michelle Ropriza, which we like this idea. Said, how are we gonna keep it on there? And she said, well, Laurent from Just Cats said suction cup and a rope. Like, well, I sleep here, so I'm not sure how that's going to work.
Laurent wanted us to do the limbo when we got in bed with the rope, and I said no.
Yeah. So I was talking to Michelle Ropriza from the Catamaran Brokerage. She said, put a suction cup with some sort of broom stick handle. So I think this is what we're going to do. We'll have to put towels or something in here to give it a pull. But that's all we can do.
Well, that's step one.
Well, step one is to... Step one is to pump the sealant down in the well. Step two is to put these on and put a little tension on this. And then step three, we're going to go outside and we're going to flex seal tape the entire bottom of the window.
That's what we're going to do.
That's the plan.
We're hoping everything holds, and then in August, so like in another month or so, we have guys in Rhode Island, they're gonna take the windows off and rebed them like the proper way.
Right.
So, but we were told this should be good enough for the next couple of months. We'll see. Because that would suck if we were sailing and that window fell out, because we get pretty wet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I saw a light.
God, this does smell so good.
It's nuts. It's terrible. This is a total boat hack. It needs to go down a little bit. Oop.
So this part over here, this is sealed, but this part down here is not sealed. So we got some bad there, good there.
And this white up here is the flex shot that we injected into there. So we just put this flex seal tape all the way around here, and now we're gonna go up the sides.
Like this section is good here.
No, you can see.
Over here it is.
I think it's the angle, right? Because you can see like all the swirl in there, that's where it's come off. You can see it's light here and dark there. That's where it's still connected, but that's not.
Right.
Right.
I don't know if you can tell, but.
Penny, for your thoughts now.
See. So this is all coming off.
can see by the light gray.
You ain't happy in your hungry.
We finally left the dock today. We have been at the Mitchell Park Marina in Greenport on Long Island up North Fork for the last five nights actually. Trying to fix some window leaks and hatch leaks, and we finally decided, man, it's time to go. So we shoved off and we're just gonna motor around Shelter Island today, just to have a change of scenery, and anchor in some place called Cockles, which I don't know anything about it other than it's a green. So that is Shelter Island. And this is the deck mess that I get to clean up now. Yay!
I'm just gonna pay my home for loose and fancy free.
Just like we found this really cool park on Shelter Island. So we anchored down there and found a cool park. But apparently you can walk with it. It's so tight you can walk across it. Women got
trouble with me. And there, but it's way over there.
I'm just your primo. Well, I'm blue as I think. Just like a playboy. Yeah, I'm blue as I think. Yeah, I'm don't have women trouble. I bring women to their knees. We'll take back to the year 2004. I had two fine looking women living.
We are rolling.
Well, we got to Cuttyhunk yesterday in the afternoon. Wind was just blowing stink, so it was nasty. We tried to come in here to this mooring field, and man, it was just way, way too tight. So we picked up a ball on the outside and decided to come in today. It's still kind of gray, but at least it's not blowing. And we're gonna take a walk around and see what's here. There's not much.
It's a huge island. I think it's like 2 miles long.
Supposedly there are some World War II bunkers this way. So we're gonna walk this trail and go find them.
Therapy.
What you chewing on there, babe?
When we were kids, I don't know what these things are, but you'd find them and you'd just basically pull them out and chew them. Lots of them on. I got two.
You're so lucky.
So we're going to chew on these things and see what happens.
Okay.
I think it cures cancer. One of them. I think it's...
You shouldn't make public statements like that.
Why? You don't know. Right? Maybe you haven't researched this yet.
Maybe.
I could be onto something.
And you did it when you were a kid and you don't have cancer.
We're doing a little over 6 knots in Buzzards Bay and we're going wing on wing. We got the head sail, the Genoa, is on a starboard tack, and the main is on a port tack. And we're doing it without even our instruments because our wind instrument is not working. Hi in there. Try to prevent it on to the main. Not the best way to do it, but okay for now. So we're doing 6-2, but we have no wind instruments. That's 6-8 when it first started, and it just dies, so it's just frozen on that. What do you think?
I think it's pretty cool. I'm cold up here, which I guess I'll have to get used to being cold for the summer.
Yeah, definitely.
And It's really neat. There are so many sailboats out today.
It looks like it's a race or something because there's so many of them going up. They're turning over there and going that way.
Yeah, there's so many. But it's cool. I'm just happy that we don't have those big old swells from behind. But I'm not seasick today, so.
Oh, that's good.
It makes me happy.
Any day that you're not seasick is a good day.
That's right. That's right. Well, I'm gonna have women in trouble. Women in trouble. We just dropped our sails because we're entering the Cape Cod Channel. The wind is from behind. We're not really sure how much wind there is because our wind instrument is not working. Thank goodness the waves are from behind. Although they do make it a little difficult to steer, put your stern up and tosses around, but take a look at this channel. You can see these waves just pick up the stern and toss it whichever way they happen to be going. So you really have to be on the ball. Supposedly there's a shallow spot right over there, so we can't really do much to get out of this guy's way except hug these markers and hope for the best. Get in the tow. Push. Get in the push.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
I was right at the edge, right at the edge of the channel. It was only like 6 feet. So I just got as close as I can. Wow. That was freaking close.
Yeah, it was. Everything is so tight here. It's crazy tight here. Right or wrong, nobody knows. Try taking the day. Oh my gosh! Look at that! Warm water around my
toes. Go, go! Oh, yeah.
Therapy.